So if you didn't know already, Rose and Ed from 90 Day Fiancé, they are through. If you didn't see that coming, well, then what were you looking at? It seemed unlikely that the two would reconcile and overcome their differences, but many of us hoped it would work out in the end. Turns out, it did not. And now crushed dreams and broken hearts lay in the aftermath of a crumbled love affair. But why? Why did they do this to us? I mean, we were all counting on them to pull it off. The unlikely match of 54-year-old Californian Ed and the 23-year-old Filipina Rose Marie, they embodied what it means to stray off the beaten path. And if they could have held it together, we all would have had the sweet, sweet encouragement that, hey, it's all going to work out. Except no, they let us down, and now we're sitting here eating way too much ice cream and pondering chasing small animals in the yard with a weed eater. Where was I going with that? Oh, right. Why did they break up? From what we see in the show, it was Rose who broke it off and ditched the hotel for an early flight home. Poor innocent Ed thinks that they can just keep talking that eventually it'll work out. But she's already gone, and the moment we've all been waiting for, let's see exactly why Rose ditched Ed. But wait, remember what we were saying about ice cream? Listen, there's a ton of content headed your way from behind the screen here. So, if you want to be ready to mourn the unhappy couple's demise by binge-watching more of our videos while giving yourself a high-quality bellyache from copious amounts of sugary dairy, then you must subscribe. And now, back to the heartbreak. Ed and Rose began their relationship online. That's nothing out of the ordinary. Tons of relationships begin that way these days. In fact, online dating has seen such a steep rise that it has become the most common way that married couples meet in America. So neither Ed nor Rose had any reason to be concerned about their virtual relationship, and it looked like they really hit it off. The two seemed madly in love with one another and desperate to connect in person. They're both pondering marriage and the beautiful life they'll have together. But there's one major problem. Ed was simply telling Rose what she wanted to hear about him and hiding his real self. Unfortunately, Rose did not find this out until Ed had traveled all the way to the Philippines looking to consummate this whole love affair. But when it all got in the open, Rose had had enough. Rose disappears for a while the morning after she and Ed had a pretty good fight. And when she emerges after having thought things through, this Filipino fireball unloads all her dissatisfaction on an unsuspecting Ed. The carnage begins with a question as to why he didn't tell her that he was certain he was done having kids when he knew good and well that she wanted a bunch more. They could have taken care of that difference online. But Ed let it progress naively, thinking that maybe if she got to know him, she would forego the babies for Big Ed. But when he puts forth this excuse, Rose claims to know exactly who he is now that they've had a few days together, and the things she's discovered are not good. She's noticed that he lied about his height, that he humiliated her by demanding she take an STD test but refusing to have one himself. And finally, the toothbrush gift debacle when he asked her to do something about her bad breath. All of these things have taught Rose that Ed was putting up a facade in their online relationship. And now that the walls are coming down, she's realized that the real Ed, not the fictional character who she fell in love with. She wraps it up by asking him to change his behavior. Not for her sake, because it's over, but to prevent him from hurting another girl in the future. Ouch! She seems to maybe even think that things might have worked out had he come clean and apologized for all the missteps. She also tells the camera crew that she misses her son. She left him back home to spend time with Ed and now feels cheated out of that time with her precious kid. Not to mention the fact that Ed, having bailed on their hopes of having a family together, surely intensified Rose's need to be with her baby boy. The last thing we hear before Rose embarks on her trip back home is that Ed respected her online. She clearly needed this and was drawn to Ed for the sake of this respect. But since they've been face to face, the respect he had for her has proven to be a complete fraud. He simply put on a show to appear to be exactly what she wanted. But that kind of front is impossible to maintain long term, and for Ed, it only lasted minutes before his true character emerged. Let's all take caution at Ed's mistakes and remember that we need to show people who we truly are. Maybe not everyone wants to see it, and that's okay. But if you're going to ask someone to invest the rest of their life in you, they need to see the demons and the skeletons you have in your closet. Now we know from watching this relationship crumble that if you try to hide it, you'll be found out eventually. So that's a wrap on this video, and that's a wrap on the saga that is Big Ed and Rose Marie. While their romance affair has gone down the drain, their story will live in infamy. Make sure to comment your favorite Ed and Rose moment. It's your last chance, and until next time, keep it classy.